Hello and welcome to Tenses Explained. Today, we are going to have a look at one of the most common tenses, the present tense. The present tense can be divided into two basic forms, the present tense simple or simple present and the present tense progressive. Let's have a look at the simple form first. We use the simple tense for things that happen regularly, all the time, or for permanent situations. It can also be used when talking about the future, especially with timetabled events. Now let's see how these forms are used.
Hey Max, do you like sports?
Yeah, sure.
Do you want to play soccer with us?
A great idea. I sometimes play volleyball, but I can give soccer a try.
Do you want to be in my team?
Of course. When do you practice?
Our practice sessions start every Monday at 6 p.m.
Sounds good. One more question. How long does a soccer game usually take? I never watch it on TV.
Soccer games usually last 90 minutes.
As you could see from the dialogue, Paul said, soccer games usually last 90 minutes to talk about the permanent situation. It was true in the past, is true now, and will be true in the future as well. He also said, practice sessions start to talk about future plans. The present simple can also be used to talk about series of events. This is the case with instructions, commentaries, and even stories. Let's have a look at how it is used, for example, in a recipe.
Kate, how do you make your chocolate brownies? They are delicious and I want to bring some to the boys' soccer practice on Monday.
It's easy and doesn't take long at all, Amy. At first take a bowl and mix eggs, flour and sugar. Then you melt some chocolate and butter.
What kind of chocolate do you use?
I like to use dark chocolate, but you can use other kinds of chocolate too. The only thing that is left is to mix everything together and finally put in some extra pieces of chocolate.
Sounds brilliant. For how long do you bake them?
It usually takes 20 minutes, but it always depends on how many you want to have.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
In this case, Kate used the present simple when talking about her recipe. For example, she said, I take, I mix, I like to use, and so on. However, there is also a second form, which is the present tense progressive. We use it when we are talking about something that is going on or is in progress at a certain moment. Things can also be going on around the time of speaking, so they start shortly before the moment of speaking and finish shortly afterwards. Let's see how this works in a real-life situation.
Hey Max, what are you doing? Where are you?
Oh, hi, I'm playing a cool game on my phone.
What? I'm waiting here in the changing room for you. We wanted to meet.
Sorry, I forgot. I'm coming. Just give me a minute.
No problem. I'm warming up in the meantime.
Thanks. See you in a bit.
In this situation, both use the present tense progressive throughout to describe what is going on at the moment. They use phrases like warming up or playing on the phone to show that something is in progress at the moment. When Paul talks about warming up, it started in the past, is relevant now, and also for the next couple of minutes. The progressive form can also be used to talk about future changes and changes from the past. Let's have a look at the dialogue and how it can be done.
Hey Oliver, what are you doing tomorrow morning? We could start working on an English project.
Sorry Harry, tomorrow I'm looking for new soccer shoes with Max.
Cool, how much are they?
I don't know, but he told me that they're getting more and more expensive.
I hope you find the right ones. So what about doing the project tomorrow afternoon then?
That sounds great.
In this example, the students were talking about future plans, but did not use a future tense. Instead, the present progressive was used. Oliver said, for example, I am looking for new soccer shoes, to talk about plans for the next day. When talking about the shoes, Oliver uses the progressive tense to talk about a change in price. As you can see, the two forms of the present tense can be used in a lot of different situations, and depending on how we use them, there can be a difference in meaning.